So today topic introduction to embedded system. So we'll brief on that introduction to embedded system. So what is the importance of embedded system? So day by day embedded system burning in our life. So the daily we are depend on the embedded applications only. So we know that what we are using daily in our daily life, like personal assistant, mobile phone, tablet, PC. Okay, like these are all many examples are there. And home appliances are daily we are using that refrigerator, washing machines, right? And telephone, television. So these are all comes home appliances. So our warning, our life warning with the embedded applications only. That is the importance of embedded system. And here, now let me talk about what is an embedded system. So embedded system, it can be defined as a electronic and electromechanical system. So defining as an electronic system and electromechanical system. It has been defining two systems, one electronic system, other one is an electromechanical system. Okay? For functioning both systems, it is required another system is there. So what is the system name is operating system. Operating system. So that means what? So embedded system, it can defining as one electronic system, electromechanical system. For functioning both systems, it is required another one is an operating system. Operating system, right? So what do you mean by embedded? Embedded means what? It's a combination of any two things. So here now we'll talk about here hardware and software. Embedded means it's a combination of hardware component and software components. So then it is going to be designed together in a chip. So embedded system. So first of all. So total definition for it is embedded system, it can be defined as electronic system, electromechanical system, and it has to perform a specific task, a specific function, and it's a combination of hardware and software. So that is for embedded system. Okay, so here, so we'll see that what are the categories of the electronic system application, electromechanical system application, characterizations of this. So here electronic system applications are mobile phone and tablet, PC, laptop, DVD player, digital camera. So this all comes under the electronic system. For electronic system must be required operating system. For electronic system must be required operating system. For electromechanical system may be required operating system. May not be required operating system. There is no guarantee for required the operating system. For an example, so air conditioner, it is an electromechanical system application, but air conditioner is not required the operating system. And another one is a remote control, and microwave. So this kind of application may not and microwave required, it is not required to operating system. So like all the electronic system may not be required, may be required to operating system. Okay, these are the applications of embedded system. So embedded system, it is a unique. So embedded system, it can be classified into three types. So how do you classify it? So three types, according to there is having some criteria. Based on the criteria, we are going to classify the embedded system. So what is that criteria? First we consider the criteria is performance and complexity. This is first criteria. And second criteria is generation. Okay? And third is the size of the processor. Based on this criteria only, so we are going to classify the embedded system. So those type of embedded systems are, first one is a small scale embedded system, small scale embedded system. Second one is the medium scale embedded system, medium scale embedded system. Third one is the large scale embedded system, large scale embedded system. Okay, so small scale, medium scale and large scale embedded system. So small scale embedded system applications are built with low power and low cost and low performance of the embedded small scale embedded system. For an example of small scale embedded systems are simple applications like toys or basic calculator. So simple small scale embedded systems are built with 16-bit microcontroller, 8-bit microcontroller or 16-bit microcontroller or microprocessor. Okay, so small scale embedded system applications are built with 8-bit or 16-bit microcontroller. So as you know that 8-bit of microcontroller is 8051, 16-bit of microcontroller is ATmega, those are the 16-bit of microcontrollers. So already we studied in that third year. And medium scale embedded system are built with the 16-bit microcontroller or 32-bit microcontroller or microprocessor. And these are medium level applications. Which are those medium level applications of small scale embedded system? That is one, ACVM, automatic chocolate vending machine. Automatic chocolate vending machine is a typical example of medium scale embedded system. So what does it is automatic chocolate vending machines? Like it is a ATM. So in automatic chocolate vending machine, just we are going to insert the coin and we collect the chocolate from the automatic vending machine, which is comes under the medium scale embedded system. So medium level complexity is there and medium performance, so those all comes in the medium scale embedded system. And comes to the large scale embedded system are sophisticated, large scale, or else we can say that sophisticated embedded system, sophisticated, that means what, complexity is more. So such kind of applications, example is mobile phone, tablet, PC, so those all which you are now using, so not those are sophisticated embedded systems. So sophisticated means what, complexity is more. Okay, so this kind of applications are designed with the 32-bit microprocessor and microcontroller or 64-bit microprocessor and microcontroller. Okay, so this is all classified of embedded system. For design, just we have seen that different applications. For what skills required as an embedded system designer for designing all those kind of applications? So for designing of small scale embedded system applications, so toys or basic calculator, what are the skills is required for as a designer? Okay, so similarly medium scale engineer also has required the some amount of skill, and large scale embedded system designer also required the large amount of the skills. Okay, time I so let us see skills required for embedded system designer. Skills required for small scale embedded system designer. As an engineer, what skill is required for designing those kind of applications? So first skill is required. First, you should have knowledge on microprocessor and microcontroller architecture. Full knowledge on this architecture. As an engineer, you should have knowledge on the microprocessor and microcontroller, full knowledge, architecture knowledge. Then only you can design the medium small scale embedded system application like the toys or basic calculator. So this is a mandatory, these skills. It's very basic. You should have full knowledge on this microprocessor and microcontroller. And next skill is you should have knowledge of the computer languages, like computer languages or programming language like C, C++ and Java, should not Java equipment. So basic program. You should have knowledge of this C language also, basic language it is. And C is very, very important. Okay. So we know that C language and C++. So C actual name of C it is, name of the language it is, compiler language it is. So C stands for compiler. So what does compiler? So we know that this is a one kind of tools. Compiler is one kind of tools which compiles the program. That means what? It is used to convert the user language into machine language. So that can do that compiler. And another one tool also is there. It's followed by the cross compiler also is there. And editor. So the editor, debugger, these are the language tools. So language tools is very, and here programming language C++, and this one. These are the language tools. So it's a basic language, C. C is a very simple language. Okay, it's very understandable and easy to understand, easy to learn this C language. So as a program, as a general, you should have knowledge of the programming language like C++. And another skill, as an engineer, should require the knowledge on the interfacing of devices. Like memory interfacing, keyboard interfacing, LCD interfacing, analog to digital interfacing. So all peripherals. We should complete knowledge on peripherals. Like peripherals, nothing but it's input and output. So this is one skill. And fourth requirement is, and you should, so basic calculator, it may be required, may not be required to operating system. But even designing, whenever designing this application, you should have some kind of knowledge on this operating system also. Operating system. So, operating system, there are different types of operating systems are there. Normal operating system, or embedded operating system, real-time operating system, and another category is mobile operating system. But is having this small basic of knowledge on this operating system. And next is, and institute of knowledge on the electronic design and designing tools and analog design. So these are the basic skills required for the smart scale embedded system designer. Okay, so these skills is common for all the applications, embedded system like medium scale and large scale. But so large scale embedded system, whenever large scale embedded system application are designed, so you should have full complete knowledge in embedded hardware and software. You should have both knowledge in this hardware and software. Whenever designing this mobile phone, so mobile phone, it is not as simple to design the mobile phone. So you should have the extraordinary skills. Then only you can design it. So what is that extraordinary skills? So this special application, no, it is. So you should have knowledge on the architecture, software, that real-time architecture also. That is what the architecture is, it can be divided into again, soft RT and hard RT. Soft real-time operating system and hard real-time operating system. And it also should knowledge on this operating system and advanced applications, advanced languages like Java, Python, COBOL. So this kind of application language skills is required for sophisticated designers. Okay, and this is about the application required the skills. Next is what are the basic components? Basic. So for these are the basic. I said these are basic skills. So saying basic knowledge and basic components of embedded system is like. So embedded system is combination of hardware and software both. So basic components required a hardware component is mandatory memory and interrupt and timer circuitry and oscillator and other peripherals. These are all basic components. So what you call it is the SOC system on chip. So all together integrated on the circuit. So that is called, it is called as an integrated circuit. System on chip is also known as IC, integrated circuit. So this is the basic concept of embedded system. Okay.